Hello everyone, today we want to take a look at Media Composer's new interface. I know that many of you are having a hard time getting used to it, so I want to show you the new bin structure, for example, the difference between bins and bin containers, and we want to take a look at the project window, what has changed about it and how I'm using it. Alright, so I'm going to create a new user profile and a new project, just so that everything looks exactly like on your computer screen. Okay, and this is how a fresh project with new user settings looks like. I have a bin container here and one bin. I'm going to create a little project structure here so you can see how I would arrange my bins. Okay, this is my test structure here. I got a music folder and a SFX folder, and both folders each contain 4 bins. All the bins that I just created were automatically opened and tapped here on the right side. So right now our project window is nothing else than a sidebar for our bins. That's something that I personally don't like. I think it's confusing. I don't want the sidebar, so I would hide it. And I would go to Tools and click on Project to have a real solid project window. Now you can just drag and drop your project window wherever you want to place it. Okay, for now I'm going to close my effects palette over here. Now I have my solid project window here and a bin container with a lot of bins in it. Okay, let's just start with our music bins. I'm going to close everything else. Here are our 4 music bins. Imagine they are all full with music. Usually I would work with a second screen, so I would move my bin container to my second screen. You can just drag and drop it out of there and let it go. And now it's independent and floating. The new interface doesn't just allow you to tap bins. You can also connect them next to each other. You can just drag and drop a tab and connect it on each side of the bin container. If you don't only want to connect a bin next to one other bin, but next to all of them, you can hold the command key on your keyboard, and this allows you to connect one bin next to several other bins. So far so good, this makes sense to me, it's actually useful. What took me a while to understand is the difference between bins and the bin container. I can connect a bin with other bins, but with nothing else. In order to connect your bins with a different tool, you have to move your bin container. This little thing here, this is your bin container. Those things here, those are your bins. You can connect your bin container with other tools, but you can connect your bins only with other bins. Let's take this out again by just moving it into empty space. But here's what I like about it. You can actually sort your bin containers. So this is right now just called bin. Let's rename this. Go to bin, set bin container name, and let's rename this to music. Now this bin container is called music. I know all my bins in it contain music. So I would probably tap them. And this is another thing you need to know. In order to tap your bins, you have to hold your option key. By holding down your option key, you're allowed to tap them. If you don't hold your option key, you're connecting them next to each other. Okay, this is how my music bins would usually look like, all tapped into each other because they are full with music and I have to scroll through them and I need a lot of space. Let's open our SFX bins. As soon as I open one, you see it's tabbing my SFX bin into my music bin container. I don't want this, I want my SFX bins in a different bin container. And this actually took me a while to figure out, because what I was trying to do, I was trying to get my bin out of the bin container and it just didn't work. It would either tap or wouldn't do anything. So here's how you get your bin out of your bin container. You drag and drop it, but not just into an empty space. You need to drag and drop it within your bin. And now I got a new bin container. I'm going to hide the sidebar here because I don't like that. So if this bin container is selected and I'm opening my bins, they are all being tapped in my new bin container. And here's the cool thing. I can now rename this bin container as well and tap my SFX bin container into my music bin container. So now I have both bin containers tapped into each other and all bins within each bin container tapped into each other as well. This is actually really useful and cool, I think, because before I would usually put my windows on my second screen like this, so I can tap through my music and I can tap through my SFX, but they would kind of be on top of each other. Now I can tap those into each other, save space, and they are nicely organized and labeled. Of course, within each bin container, I can still move my bins around, click them into each other, and organize them the way I want to, if I don't just want to tap them into each other. But here's another confusing thing about it. Let's untap those two. I can just move it into empty space, no matter where. If I want to tap this bin container with another tool, I have to hold down the Option key in order to tap them. If I want to tap it with another bin container, I don't have to press any button. So this is something that's hard to remember for me. In order to tap a bin container with other tools, hold down the Option key. In order to tap it with other bin containers, you don't have to hold down anything. If you don't want to tap your bin container with another tool, but just connect it, you can of course just go to one of those green areas and then let your bin container go. So now it's connecting next to my tools. Ah, okay, I just this second actually learned something new. Once your bin container is connected with other tools, you also have to press the Option key to tap them into each other. So the tabbing option confusion is not about bin containers, it's about if a bin container is already connected to something else. If I want to connect those bin containers, I don't have to press the Option key because the music bin container is not connected to anything else. If I want to connect a bin container that's already connected to something else, then I have to hold down the Option key. Very interesting. Okay, let's get those bin containers out of the way for now. And let's take a look at our project window. This used to have all kinds of really useful settings here on the top. It was really easy to navigate through them and to find everything fast. Those settings are now all a little hidden. So to find your project settings, you go to File, Settings. So what I do in order to kind of get my old super bin with all my settings back, I'm tabbing them into each other. Remember, hold the Option key down. Now I'll get my project window and my settings next to each other. Your settings are actually now divided into project settings and user settings. This is a little confusing at first, but actually makes sense and is really helpful because now you know which settings are just affecting your user and which settings are affecting the project. I would also go to Tools and open my Effects palette and also tap that into here with Option to kind of get my old super bin back. Another thing that's good to know is once you've closed your bins, they are opening up in a new fresh bin container that's just called Bins again. So once you've renamed your bin container and organized your bins, try not to close them again, because otherwise you have to reorganize and relabel them again. If this video is helpful, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and check out my other Avid tutorials as well. Thanks so much for watching and see you next time.